Today we are talking about systematic negotiation. During negotiation, part 2. That's to say, what phases must be planned for the negotiation itself. I'm José Manuel García-Lomas and Allen-Perkins, President and First Consultant of the firm García-Lomas and Allen-Perkins, the ADO Corporation. The video we developed today, Systematic Negotiation During Negotiation Part 2, it refers to the phases to be planned for the negotiation itself. But going into the own negotiation, we will distinguish here as well as in before a negotiation, 8 phases that require a careful systematic study. Phase 1, establishing our opening position. The opening position for each issue or combination of issues should be set highly realistically and above your estimate of the bottom line of the other part, to allow room for concessions. Although highest aspirations lead to better results if agreement is reached, they can also lead to more deadlocks. And certainly high and realistic aspirations can frighten or offend the other part and thus drive them out of the negotiation. Phase 2. Establishing our bottom line. Setting a baseline below which no agreement at all is better than any offer that the other part may make. We will alter the baseline only if it is justified by new information or new developments. The baseline is the point below which it would be best to reject any offer or demand. Substantial differences between baselines constitute the ground for agreement. Baselines are established for negotiation as a whole, also for each issue in a multiple issue negotiation. Phase 3, defining strategies and tactics. The choice of strategies and tactics should always be based on each particular negotiation, rather than on the personal habits of the negotiator. Even professional diplomats have difficulty following this principle. Their political leaders and their culture can create predictable strategies and tactics. Whenever possible, try to be unpredictable in order to minimize the other part's ability to plan. Choose alternative strategies and tactics in each negotiation to be used in case the first choice of strategies and tactics proves ineffective. Anticipate each other's strategies and tactics and identify appropriate countermeasures. Be prepared to start and how you will react. Phase 4, valuing concession and exchanges. The different value that each part places on an issue to be negotiated creates the opportunity for exchanges. An exchange should be seen as a process of choosing a theme, judging that theme, deciding which option will work most effectively for us and the other part. Phase 5, planning for concessions and exchanges, covers several important functions. 1. It allows for the creation of apparent concessions which the negotiator does not care about, except for their exchange function. Example, to grant something for a reciprocal concession later that is of real value to us. 2. Allow the negotiator to generate several small concessions to give them in critical moments of the negotiation, and thus avoid having to make big concessions. 3. Allow the negotiator to conceive persuasive reasons for each potential position. This is not easy to do during the negotiation itself. 4. Allow the potential value of the exchanges to be established in advance. Phase 6. Setting the agenda. The term agenda refers to the order in which A. issues will be considered, B. actions will be taken, and C. concessions will be made during the negotiation process. A decision should first be made if it is appropriate to establish an agenda with the other part, the own agenda always. If necessary, the agenda itself may be subject to negotiation. Individual agenda, one part. Individual hidden agenda, one part. Agenda to be established by both parts. And now phase 7, setting the timing. Establishing the time of the negotiation so that it is developed when it is more advantageous. By controlling timing, a negotiator may be able to control the amount of information known by the other part, as well as increase the pressure exerted to act. The optimal time to negotiate is 1. When our part is under less pressure to make an agreement than the other part. 2. Before the need of our side becomes more pressure, creating additional pressures. 3. When we have enough information about the situation to negotiate intelligently. Phase 8, choosing the types of negotiation to develop. After deciding on the right time to negotiate, the final step is to choose the model of communication to use. The choice will be between A, face-to-face meetings, B, group meetings, C, meetings by the video conference, D, a combination of different modes of communication. The negotiator should consider whether a mode of communication might be perceived as a strange, difficult, inappropriate, offensive, or as a pretext for delaying the negotiation. And finally, an important secret is to be firm in the objectives and flexible in the means, and never underestimate the other part or its negotiator history. Constantly reminds us for the mistake of foolishly underestimating or ignoring the true capabilities of the other part. And remember, he who hides his strengths doubles it. If you are interested in our videos, I suggest that you give a like and subscribe to our channel for the videos that are to come.